It was super tempting to give this a title like BookTube Favorites I'm Not Reading Anymore or something else super clickbaity like that. And honestly, I still might because I make the titles after I film. So I don't know, but I guess you do. Did I sell out? Hi everyone, Rosie here. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. This is a continuation of my series about series. Today I'm going to talk about the book series that I don't want to finish. The first series that I can happily say I'm not going to read any more of is A League of Extraordinary Women by Evie Dunmore. This is a romance series. The first book in it is Bringing Down the Duke, which is the one you've probably heard of. There is a second one published and a third one coming out in 2021, I think. All of the books in this series follow different women who are involved in the suffragette movement in Victorian England and various ways that they meet and fall in love with people. When I first read Bringing Down the Duke, it was a fine but not amazing read. I enjoyed it enough, I guess, but I didn't love it. And then I started talking about it with Lana and Crystal because we did a buddy read for it, and then I realized that there were so many issues that like my brain just glossed over and didn't even pay attention to, and that actually I didn't like this book so much. I'm going to try and find and link Lana's video where she talks about this book because she articulates it so much better than I do. But essentially, yeah, on further reflection, this was fine, but not that good, and there's so many other fun, light series that I want to read that I can happily say goodbye to this one. The next series is one that I actually thought I would read more of when I read the first book, but when I was compiling this list, I realized it just wasn't that interesting to me, and that is Fred the Vampire Accountant by Drew Hayes. This is an urban fantasy novel that throws everything we typically see in the genre on its head. Yes, our main character is a vampire, but he was a boring accountant when he was alive, and 2 years after his death, he's still a boring accountant. He has none of our typical vampire protagonist traits. When I read the first out of these 6 books this summer, I'll link a vlog or a wrap-up or something up here, I actually, like I said, quite enjoyed it. I thought it was fun, but not great, and I thought I would continue. And I think maybe if I'd had internet connection while I read the first one, I might have picked up the second and read it then, but honestly it was one of those books where when I put it down it was good and then I just never think about it and I never am interested to reach for it. There are so many other urban fantasy series that I would like to read and that I think I will enjoy more. This one just didn't have great narrative structure, the writing wasn't that good, it just didn't work for me, and maybe that was just first book problems. Maybe as the series continues and we have a more established cast of characters, it would have gotten better. I just didn't like it enough to even bother trying. Honestly, I feel sort of like I'm stopping a TV show after the pilot, but it just didn't grab me at all. It had all the elements of a really good series, cool setting, cool ideas about creatures, you know, breaking the stereotypes about all these different kinds of creatures and stuff. It just didn't really amount to anything once I'd actually read it. I seem to be on a thing with the light and fun series that I don't want to continue. I don't know what that says about me or my reading. But next up is The Pirates by Gideon Defoe. I have to go, The Pirates, because it's The Pirates with an exclamation mark. So you've got to do it, right? This is a comedy adventure series about a crew of pirates, I think Victorian era, but it might be kind of unclear, I can't remember. And basically they're having adventures on the high seas and it's very funny. And the one that I read, I think it was The Pirates in an Adventure with Scientists or something like that. They come across Charles Darwin and make friends with him and end up going on a big adventure to help him do something science related. I can't remember. As you can see, this book suffered not from being terrible. I don't remember hating it. It was just really unmemorable and not as funny as I'd hoped, I think. There is a movie that I remember really, really loving and enjoying so much that is based on that first book. So I think I'd seen the movie, then I saw the book somewhere and thought, I should pick that up. That sounds really fun. Humor, scientists, wacky adventure. I like that sort of book, or at least I think I like that sort of book. But when I actually read it, it just was very, very meh, unfortunately. So I don't feel I need to finish that. And finally, this last series, yes, only 4, we'll talk about that after, is the Wayfarer series by Becky Chambers. It's the one that starts with The Long Way to a Small Angry Planet. Those of you who've been around for even a little while will not be surprised to hear me say that I don't want to finish this series. I have spoken numerous times about how The Long Way to a Small Angry Planet is my book that I just don't get. Not in that like I didn't understand the plot, but in the sense of I don't get why everyone loves it. It's also been a long time since I read this one, so I don't have detailed notes on why I don't like it. I think basically it was a character-driven story where I didn't feel like I was actually connecting with the characters at all. I shouldn't say too much because I can't remember exactly why I didn't like this book. I just know that I really, really did not enjoy the first one and therefore have no interest in reading anymore. I might give something else by Becky Chambers a try at some point because everyone loves her writing so much and I'm the only one who doesn't. So maybe I'll try again, but for now, I don't need to continue reading this series. And yes, yet another incredibly short list. My least favorite books of 2020 was a very short video, possibly the shortest I've ever posted. Possibly until this one. I guess I just don't have a lot of negative things to say. Or rather, when I'm doing a review of an individual book, I can have negative things to say. But when I'm talking about a lot of things in general, I find it harder to critique. Maybe I should just strap the camera to my partner's head and like pretend it's not there, because when I'm ranting at him about books, I have so many thoughts and I can go on for so long. And then I sit down in front of the camera and all of a sudden it's just like, well, it just wasn't for me and I didn't like it. And that's all I can say. I'm sorry. Don't think I'm ever going to be one of those great ranty channels, which I enjoy watching so much. Another reason this video is very short though is that I really just didn't have that many series where I had absolutely no interest in picking up another. There were some that I was more excited about, the ones I talked about in my book series I'm definitely going to read more of. And in a week or two, I can't remember when now, there's going to be another video about all of the book series where I'm like, well, it's not a priority right now, but it's also not a no. I think that's where most of my books that I'm not super excited about fell, because I don't hate them. It's not that I never want to read another, it's just I'm not in the mood for them right now, or they're not priorities right now. Anyway, this has been enough long-winded padding of this video, so let me know down below. Are there any series that you've DNF'd? Do you DNF series often? Or are you more like me where you sort of keep them on the reserve? Maybe you'll pick them up someday, but it's been 10 years since you looked at one. As always, if you liked this video, please hit the like button down below. If you would like to see more of my videos, please hit subscribe, and thank you for watching.